This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on the Lord of Pestilence from Avatars of War. Got several things that I want to do on the miniature today. I want to try and get most of this this sort of standard on his back painted up, or totem, or whatever we want to call it. Set of trophies, I don't know. And so we'll do that. And then what I want to do is I want to take a look and see if I can maybe come up with a different way of doing the armor, because the way that I tried it here several episodes ago, I got some dust on the model there, sorry, it just doesn't look great to me. It's not quite exactly what I'm looking for. There may be a better way to do it, and so I'm just going to test a few things out, maybe up here on like the shoulder pauldron, maybe the wrist here, maybe the sword. Just some areas that I can find that are kind of flat that I can test a couple of ideas out on. But before we do that, let's go ahead and base coat the... Late in the day, a little tired. I'm going to go ahead and base coat the skulls on the model's totem area thing here, whatever we want to call it. I think I'm going to call it a standard. I don't really know what it is. Just going to base coat these out really quickly. And hope for the best. The way I'm going to do these is these little spiky things coming out of the tops of the heads. I think I'm going to treat that as like pieces of the wood here that have grown out of the tops of the skulls somehow. I'm not really sure how that would work, but I think it would look cool. So that's what we're going to do. Just go ahead and paint all or the rest of them while I'm back here. Some infected like pustules here on the skulls. That's interesting that, you know, normally when you think nerdly stuff, you think, you know, people that are alive and are infected with some sort of horrible disease. And here we actually have skulls, remnants of people that have these, you know, buboes or plague touches to them, which is actually kind of an interesting concept. It sort of opens up the door for an undead sort of Nurgle possession. That'd be kind of interesting. I don't recall anywhere in Games Workshop lore that has ever been explored before. I mean, could you imagine like a Nurgle vampire or a Nurgle mummy or something like that? Something where you would almost combine two ancient evils into one. That would be very unique. Alright, so that is mixed up there. Now the next thing I'm going to do, just for a placeholder, I'm going to go ahead and mix together my wood color again. So I've got some of that mixed there on my palette here, and I'm just gonna do that. I need a little bit more of my brown mixed into that, so let me do that real quick while you guys wait. And get a little more water too. There we go. Okay. And rinse that brush out. Now, go back to my other brush. I can do it without throwing it all over the place. Alright, and what I'm going to do here is just sort of add in some color, as I said, kind of as a placeholder. Just sort of want to see how this is all going to work together, get rid of as much white space as I can in the area that I'm working. And, you know, if I happen to get some paint onto this area when I go back in to paint the highlights on the skulls, I'm not going to be overly concerned about it because, as I said, it's just a placeholder. It's just sort of to give me an idea of how the colors are going to play together, and it's not that big of a deal. If I happen to get some of this color, or some of the another color, into this one. So, I'll just apply it liberally and not really worry about it. Okay. There we go. And let's front real quick here. Kind of touch that area. Okay, most of the front here looks pretty good. Need to do the top part of this. I think this is actually going to look pretty cool. You're going to have these really, really, really bone white structures at the very top of the model, but you're going to have them mounted on these incredibly dark pieces of wood. So I think that'll look really well as far as being a good contrast for everything here. All right, so this is going to be wood. I suppose you could technically paint these as like actual horns coming out of the skulls, but I don't think it would look as good. I mean, there's obviously like little wraps and things like that around some of these little horns. And why would you wrap a horn? You know, you might wrap it if you were trying to tie it to something, so that's why I'm kind of thinking that these are bits of the wood. They're just extended through the horns. Or extended through the skull, excuse me. Alright, there's that. Let me touch the tip of that one since I touched it with my finger. And we'll come in. We'll just add that color in there. Spin her around. Do that. Spin it a little more. And do that. Okay. Obviously, the chains are going to be metallic, so I will avoid those for now. Come back in and paint those in a few minutes. All right, so for right now, we'll call that good. Now I need to apply a wash over the skulls. And I'm going to do that, and that wash will take a few minutes to dry, and at that point, we can switch over and start working on the armor just a little bit and just see if we can come up with a decent plan for the armor. So let me get some of this wash in my brush. Get some water in it. It's a little thick. Alright. So I'm just going to do this right here very quickly. Alright. Almost a bloody look to it. That will disappear, but this wash is a great, great way to work on bone. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to let that sit and dry for a few minutes. Now let's deal with the armor. Okay, so I don't know if you can tell or not, but the sparkly color that I did the armor originally is not really all that sparkly. I mean, you've got a few areas where you can kind of see some sparkles, but it's not unbelievably bright. Now, what I'm thinking is, if I go with this method that I've got right here, what I'll have to do is, for every highlight that I add in, I'll have to add another drop or two of that metallic medium. And what I noticed as I was putting that metallic medium on the first time when we did this was that it actually lightened up the color just slightly, but it did lighten it up. And so what I'm going to have to do if I go with this method is I'm going to have to go to a darker tone than I would normally go to overcompensate for that lightening of the metallic medium. But there's a couple of other ideas that I've got. And so I want to try those out. And so the first thing I want to do is I want to take a little bit of black, and we're going to do this over on one of the shoulder pauldrons. So let me put the black away. All right, so I'm going to get my brush. This may take a moment or two to dry, but I'm going to try and apply it to just a small little area here. Let's use this little shoulder pauldron here, right here. Okay, now all of this is going to get painted over at some point anyway. I'm just sort of testing things out, so it's not that big a deal. So we're going to use that as our spot to test one idea. Okay. And then let's see here. What else do we want to do? Let's take some of that metallic medium and mix it into the black. That was another thing I was thinking about. If I can find the metallic medium, that's going to be the next task. Where in the world did I put it? Great question. Don't. Oh, it's over here. Hey. I love when I lay stuff on my desk behind something, and it's fantastic. That's why you always put things back where you find them. Okay, so we've got our black. That's actually just about dry. So I'll tell you what, let me go ahead and do this real quick here. I'm going to mix some of this medium in. I'm going to change my water cup as well, because I don't want any metallic flakes in my normal water. And let's see, I need a nice sizable brush for this to do my mixing. Okay, I'm going to use this. At some point, we'll get there. Okay, so what I've got here, just sort of roughing some colors together. But you can see that metallic medium is awfully bright. And I'm just going to take this brush here and just sort of mix it together just to see kind of what it produces. So that produces sort of a steel color. In fact, I could probably utilize like a really, really, really dark, just a dark steel. And that would probably work just as well. So I think I might actually be able to use, let's see, what could we use? Maybe Lead Belcher, if we wanted to go with one of the newer paints from GW. That might work actually fine. But for now, let's just give this a go and see what happens. Okay, so I'm just going to pick some of this up. And let's go to, let's go to this sword right here. Okay, so we're just going to paint that right there. I'm going to let that dry. Now, while that's drying, I am going to take some metallic medium by itself, and I'm going to apply it to the black area that I painted previously. Okay, so let me get a little of this in my brush. I've watered it down significantly, although I probably should not have watered it down quite that much. But I'm more curious to see kind of how it's going to dry if I just paint medium on this thing. Because what I'd like to do, if I can do it, is an old car painting technique where you lay down the metallic sheen first and then you cover it with a bunch of different glazes. That would be ideal. But I don't think it's going to work because I don't think this is going to dry clear and just leave my metallic flakes behind. I think this is going to dry with a sheen to it, sort of a whitish or a grayish sheen. Okay. All right, so I'm just going to let that sit and dry for a few moments. And let's see here. That's not quite dry yet. Nope. Okay, so let's test out the main idea of just coloring the green, or metallicizing, I don't know, making the green metal, let's put it that way, and I'll do that maybe on that shoulder pauldron up there. Okay, so let me drop some green here, let's do that, and then I need to add some black to it to make it darker, and I need to wipe this paint off my finger, because yuck. Alright. I hate getting paint on my finger and not realizing it, because then it usually ends up on something that I'm painting. Okay, so there's that. So let's add a little black to my green. Here, I'll show you what I'm doing. How about that? There we go. Okay, so there's my blob of green. I'm going to add some black to that. There you go. That's good enough. And we're just sort of throwing colors together here. I'm not really taking ratios or anything like that. I want to see if this is dark enough before I do anything else. That's pretty dark. Okay, good dark green. I like it. So let's add a little bit of this in, or a lot of bit of that. Whatever, you know, either way works. Mix that in. Alright, so do you see how it lightens the color? I don't know if you can see that or not, but you can see there's a pretty significant difference in the pre-metallic, post-metallic. This is almost like a minty sort of a color. And so, if I do this, I'm going to have to add a lot more black to this mixture. And because of the metallic, the way the metallic sort of shines, I'm going to have to go, I think, towards the white side of the highlighting scale as opposed to the yellow side of the highlighting scale, which is unfortunate because I would prefer to go towards yellow. But it doesn't matter. We'll get there. We'll find something that works. That's the important part, just working on something that works. So I'm going to take this, and I'm just going to apply it, say, up here in this area. Okay, I need a little bit thicker coat than that, so let's add a little more. Okay. Alright, so I'm just going to do that, and let's see here. I think in the end, I can't remember what I said I was going to do with these shoulder pauldrons anyway. I don't think I was going to paint them green. I don't know, I'll have to go back and take a look at some of the, take a look at the video from a couple hours ago, because I just don't recall. But anyway, alright, so let's see here. We've got, is this dry? That's dry. Great, great, great. So now what I want to do is I want to take a glaze, or I want to create a glaze. So let's do that real quick. Just take some green, put that there, and probably wipe my finger off again. No, I didn't have to. Excellent. Okay, so we're going to make a glaze now. Where's my green? There's my green. Alright. Lots of water. Just dropping water. Not even close. There we go. Okay. That's decent. It's not great, but we're doing this on the fly, and we're doing it kind of haphazardly just as a test, so it's not that big of a deal. What I want to do is I want to take that, and I want to apply it on top of this. Think it's going to end up as way too light, but I'm not sure. So we'll just keep on applying little bits of color over and over and over again. Okay. Alright, I'll have to let it dry for a few moments. While it's drying, what I'm going to do is come back into this metallic green that I've created here and add a little bit more green, regular green. Where? Okay, I was wondering why my finger kept getting wet every time I laid it down. Okay, so I'm going to drop that down and mix that in. Let's do that. Okay, but see here at this point, because I've added regular paint but no metallic medium, I get a lighter color, I get something closer to green, but I lose a little of that metallic flake. So, let's add in some more metallic. Okay. You can see the color shifts a little bit, even doing that. Just a little. Not much. Okay. Oh, hello. Throw in my brush. Alright, so I'm going to pick a little of that up here, just a bit. And I'll apply that, let's say, kind of up here in this area. I just want to see kind of what a transition might look like on this model. Okay. Not too bad. Grab a little bit more of that glaze here while we wait. The first layer should be dry. Just apply that again over these areas. Okay. at the 20-minute mark. We're going to go for a couple more minutes here while I continue to test some of these ideas. Add a little bit more green. Actually, that was a lot more green. And learning from last time, I'm going to have to add a little bit more metallic flake as well. Okay, so let's get that in frame. There we go. Alright, so we're going to mix all this up, yeah. Okay, so basically what I've got here is my normal standard green with some metallic in it. And that's fine. That's good. This will lead me towards how to highlight. Okay, so I'm just going to take some of that right off the palette. Not even going to worry about rinsing my brush out. And come up here and touch that color up in here some. And let's see here, are those glazes dry? You're getting there. Let me do a little bit more here. Okay, more glazing here. More glazing here. Okay. You know, I gotta tell you, I think this one down here is actually working out pretty good. Basically, the idea with this glaze, it's an old car painting technique that I learned years and years and years and years ago. I was probably, I don't know, 12, 13 years old. But basically, what you do is you lay down a base coat of some sort of metallic paint, just a metallic flake, and then you cover it with layer after layer after layer after layer after layer of a thin see-through glaze. And what I saw was like a Corvette or something like that. I can't remember exactly what it was, but they were spraying it with a nice candy apple red, and it had a gold underlay on it, and it was really, really came out nicely. But I don't know, that may work. Let's try working with this normal highlighting here. So I'm going to take, let's see, we want to go towards the yellow side, and so let's just do it this way, grab some yellow. Okay. Now this I'm going to have to be a little careful with, because this yellow will overpower everything, I think. Let's just lay a bit of that down. Continuing to work with my metallic paint, my metallic brush. I gotta add in some more metallic flake here. There we go. More water. Okay. Mix that up real good. There we go. Alright, so you can see we've made some progress here in our colors. Let's just take a little of that and maybe put it up here. Okay. Alright, so what I'm noticing is that this over here looks like metallic green. Okay, so let me kind of kill some of the light so you can see that. You can see the paint reflecting through that far more than you can see this having any sort of a sheen to it at all. So I gotta tell you, I think that might be the way to go. And what I'll end up having to do then is I'll end up having to reverse the way that I paint this guy, painting from basically light to dark instead of dark to light. So I think we found our answer. And I think the answer is going to be coat the entire guy in a very, very, very dark metallic steel color and glaze the hell out of him. That's going to create a very lengthy series because I'm going to have to let these layers of glaze dry. But I think in the end, I think it's going to end up looking much, much better. And I can even come in. What I can do, actually, is I can paint the entire guy in various colors of steel, going from very, very dark in the shadows to very light on the highlights, and that will take care of most of my highlighting, because the glaze will be essentially see-through. And so all the highlights and the shadows will show through that green glaze. So that, I think, is going to be the way that we're going to roll. So excellent. I'm glad I did this little test. It gave me some insight as to the way I needed to work this thing. So for right now, we'll call it a video. Hopefully you guys picked up some little tips and tricks on how to do some testing on your own miniatures if you were looking for that. If you happen to have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Again, I want to thank you for watching. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.